Right.
Action.
Thank you. We're strangers, I was. Talk about the wonder, and I would rather be someone else. Dreams are still dreams, no matter how bad you need sleep. Puddles are still puddles, are still puddles. No matter how deep, and we are sometimes like fire and glitter. Something in our shape. No concept to drive around to cold and confused. Falling and I believed you. Needed help. We're strangers always. Talk about the weather. And I'm a weather. Be someone else.
Thank you.
What's up, Minneapolis, you know what I'm saying? Anybody, Twin Cities in the house? Back on. It's been a while since I've been through here. I recognize a couple faces. But now I realize I really want to thank you for coming out tonight, but I realize some of these routines are going to be new, so it's going to be hard for you to juggle along in your seat. I understand that. Hopefully you'll have a good time anyway. Now check it out. Last week, we had a couple people here from England. They showed up, they were in the house. Anybody else here from the UK this week? Anybody else here from the United Kingdom? Maybe not just England, but any other countries? Nobody's here. All right, be that way. We got a couple kids here from Ireland, actually. And I was gonna tell a little story about them, but since they don't wanna speak up, I mean, we could skip the story. Are you? There they are. What's up? Couldn't see you because all those bright lights, you know? Up here on stage, you know, it's all crazy. But check it out. I picked these kids up from the airport. What was it, like Wednesday? It doesn't matter. It was this week. And they just spent 3 months in Australia and then a couple weeks, 3 weeks, whatever, in Hawaii. Okay? I pick them up and they all come off the airplane wearing t-shirts and sandals with no socks, you know? And I'm like, well, to Minneapolis, you know, welcome. It's gonna be lots of fun here, lots of surfing this time of year. That's right. I think it's about time now to introduce y'all to a couple of my good friends. Over here we got Ocean and Jayoe. Right on. Showing some love. They're gonna be sticking around for the whole show. I think you guys gonna be here? Right, well it looks like it's gonna be a great show. What you been doing since you know, last time I saw you, like last week?
I haven't been doing much. Apparently you've been hanging out with, you know, good UK people.
Yeah, people from the UK are good. You know, you can't beat them. Except for that whole disease thing. In the livestock, come on, people. You know what I'm saying?
The whole foot and mouth.
The whole foot, thank you very much. The foot and mouth thing. I'm not saying people from the UK have diseases.
But I hear over there they call it something else. They call it hoof and mouth.
Hoof and mouth. Well, thank you. We didn't know that, and now, you know, we're all much better off for it. Whew, Jayoe's awful quiet right now. No, I didn't say that was a bad thing. I think it's time to move the show along just a little bit farther down the road. Just time to move on. But check it out. Should we do the? Do you want to do the? What are we gonna do? The three ball.
Do
you want to do the three ball thing?
I'm here to do what you want.
Cool. All right. Well, let's do the three ball thing. But oh, you know what? I have to go get the three balls. I need some three ball getting music. So, see what you can do. Just any time, I'm gonna go get the three balls. Three ball getting music.
Has a dream late at night, wakes up with a vision of children in wheelchairs chasing him down Ventura Boulevard in the heart of Hollywood. Michael Jackson's running from the disabled children. He looks around and he sees that the sun is very bright outside, and he sees it as a hot day in February. And it fills his face beginning to just slide off. And the children cry, hey, hey, hey. Michael Jackson. Hey, hey, hey. Michael Jackson. Michael Jackson calls his boa constrictor on the telephone. And the boa constrictor says, you gotta get away, Mike. You gotta get away, Mike. Michael Jackson goes to Disneyland. Michael Jackson goes to Disneyland. In Disneyland, there are many people in animal suits selling hot dogs. Saying, hey, hey, Michael Jackson. Hey, hey, hey. Michael Jackson. Michael Jackson is lost in a sea of big people. He looks around and all he sees are big people in line. Michael Jackson looks around. Who is that guy? That's not my dad. Who is that guy? Michael Jackson. And he's coming forward, and he's smiling, and he's got these big teeth. And Michael's looking at Axl Rose, and he says, "Who is that guy?" "That's not my dad." "Who is that guy?" "That's not my dad." Hey, hey, hey. Hey, hey, hey. Michael Jackson.
Oh,
you very much. I really appreciate the support. And no, seriously, I do. It's really good that everybody came here. And I'd just like to say, what's up, Minneapolis?
Still out St. Paul.
Yeah, St. Paul, right? Like the whole...
The Twin Cities.
The Twin Cities, right? Like, that's so weird. Did you ever think that, Ocean, did you ever think like that? Like Minneapolis and St. Paul, the Twin Cities, you know? Did Minneapolis ever make St. Paul go to school and take a test for him? Like, because they're twins? Baseball team? Right on. But never mind that. I gotta set this next piece up a little bit. See? I have this friend. He's basically the Michael Jordan of juggling. Not that he's retired, but he's just really good. And so I called him a couple of days ago on the phone, and I said, how do you do what you do, and how, I don't know. You know, I said, how do you do what you do? You know, and basically he said, well, number one, to juggle well, you have to practice. You know, and I'd heard of that before. So I thought, okay, you know, right on, I understand. And then he said, there's two things that feed good juggling. The first one is love, and the second one is anger. It's not hate, because hate leads to anger. So love and anger. And he said, most of the time, I juggle with a feeling of love. And then sometimes when I drop, it changes to anger, and then maybe eventually back to love. So I'd like to think that this next piece is all about the love.
And the towers are the same, and miles are the days.
To you, the musical stylings of Ochen K and Jayoe. Jayoe. Thank you. Again. Really good. There are a lot more material to cover tonight, so we don't have time for a lot of that. Don't fear, there'll be chances later on. To tell you a little bit about this next piece, it's sort of, I don't know if it's as interesting as it is important for you to know. I have this friend, he's from England, he lives in Germany, I met him in Finland, he really gets around, he's a nice guy. The thing about him is he has two thumbs, but I'm talking about his one thumb in particular, because see, he has this habit, and he has a knife, and he has a thumb, and if it's really bloody, he just sort of whittles away at his thumb. It's a nervous habit, and it's not like those things you read about in teenage magazines about cutting yourself, you know, not one of those. But it's just one of his nervous habit. And, you know, he'll just sit there and talk to you and cut at his thumb. He doesn't have a thumbnail, it's just really bad. His name is Luke, and I say, Luke, why do you do that? And he says, I don't know that I do it, but it makes me feel better. And so I started thinking about this next piece I'd like to perform for you. And if you will sort of bear with me, I call it My Luke's Thumb, because I don't know how good it is for you to watch, or for the show, or for art in general, but it makes me feel good.
Ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta
let's show the dog some love, people. That was pretty good. I don't think he dropped once. Heck of a dog. And now, a couple more dogs. Ochen Kaylan and Jayoe.
Johnny Jones was serenading Mary. He sure could quote a lot of poetry, but he'd much rather tell her what he learned in his speller when they both attended the S-43. You're adorable. You're so beautiful. You're a cutie full of charms.
D.
You're a darling and
E.
You're exciting.
F.
You're a feather in my
arms. G.
You look good to me.
H.
You're so...
Ha 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 ha
Pretty good here. Figure out, you guys okay back there?
I'm good. Jayoe, you good?
Good. We're all really excited right now to perform for you. You guys excited?
Yeah.
I'm excited.
Yeah.
Jayoe, you excited?
I'm kind of thirsty.
We got chocolate milk. Ochen, you want any chocolate milk?
I'm good, thanks.
Okay. We're getting our own show on NPR. Those improv classes are paying off. All right. Where were we? Out of control. Okay, thanks, Ochen. So I want to tell you a little story about this next piece. Oddly enough, we got a brochure in the mail a couple of days ago to go to Disney World, and I was all happy. It's a happy place, and I went there with my family about 3 or 4 years ago, and it was on New Year's Eve, around 10 p.m. So all the rides were shutting down. The park, of course, was open until about 1. They had all the fireworks at midnight for New Year's. And it was pretty nice. So I'm there with my brother, and we go on the jungle boat, river boat jungle tour, which is basically, you know, it's a car driving through about a foot of water, and they have a tour guide. He has a nice little outfit. You know, it's really nice. But I want to talk about, you know, more what he was saying, because they have a script, right? They have this script that they follow. Something like, okay, welcome to the jungle riverboat jungle tour, and on your right you'll see some animals eating some aborigines, and have a nice day. stuff like enjoy your stay here, and oh look, there's some more rhinoceros like killing the other people, and it's fun, and you know, all this stuff. So, and they're all like animatronic, right, like sort of aborigines like killing each other and eating each other, but it's just fake, so it's okay. And but they have this script that they say, and you know, it was clear that this guy had been doing this job for just way too many years of his life. And it's New Year's Eve, and he has to work, and he has to entertain us. And it's the last tour he's giving of the evening. And so he's just a little out of it, and because I don't think that Disneyland employees can do drugs. I think he was just gone. I think he was really mad. And he wasn't, I don't think he was sticking to the script, is what I'm trying to tell you. And so he was just sort of like, driving. Now on your left, if you'll look. No, you missed it. Okay. Up ahead around the bend, you'll see. Oh, forget it. It's not that exciting. So, you know, he's talking like this. And then comes the point in the script where he takes the fake gun. And he's supposed to shoot it at the crocodile that comes up out of the water and kill the crocodile. And so we're just sitting there, and this crocodile pops up out of the water and sort of roars and then goes back underneath the water, and he takes out the gun and goes, psh, oh, I missed. And then he goes, psh, oh, we're all gonna sink. Are you listening to me? I don't think you're listening to me. You know, and at which point we were listening to him. You know, we had a nice long chat. But what I thought I would do is I'd try to make a piece for my show that was just so bloody boring that through sheer repetition, it would be more fun. So I've endeavored to do that, and this next piece is called Disneyland. That's all I have to say about that.
Thank you. say quarter. We're rolling with the dopes in our one. We're rolling with the wrong one on ya. We're going down to Baltimore. We're going in an off-white Honda. But I miss the girl, miss the girl, miss the girl. I wanna give myself a water. But I miss the girl, miss the girl, miss the girl. I wanna give myself a water.
Years old, like the football, 20 years old. Thanks, Lulu.